Good afternoon, students. In today's class, we are going to learn how to locate an irrational number on number line, and we are also going to see exercise 1.2 and how to convert a decimal into rational form, that is P by Q form. So let's start. So coming to our first topic, that is how to locate an irrational number on number line. For example, you will get the question like this. Locate root 2 on number line. We know what is mean by the number line. Number line is your what we have seen in the previous class, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. And from the left hand side, what you will see, minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. Okay. Here on number line, I have just represented integers. That doesn't mean other numbers are not present on the number line. All the real numbers we can represent on number line. Okay, but representing integer or any decimal, that is the rational form, rational number is comparatively easy as compared to irrational number, because we don't know the value of root 2. As root 2 is irrational number, we know that a irrational number is a number or a decimal whose digits after the decimal point are not repeating and also not terminating. So this 41 will not be repeated again, it will not be terminated. That's why root 2's value is not fixed, not a perfect value we are not getting. Okay, and that's why we are not able to perfectly locate root 2 on number line. So approximately we have to locate, and we have to see how we can locate a irrational number. So now, to locate an irrational number on number line, we are going to use the Pythagoras theorem. I believe all of you know the Pythagoras theorem. In right angle triangle, what we have seen, in right angle triangle, let me draw straight. Let's suppose this is a right angle triangle. Okay. Right angle triangle A, B and C. We know that the square sum of the squares of two sides, that is AB square plus BC square. This is one side, this is the second side. Sum of squares of these two sides is equal to the square of hypotenuse. We know the hypotenuse, which is AC. This is our Pythagoras theorem. This we have seen in the previous class. Now we are going to use this Pythagoras theorem to find the value of root 2 geometrically, and then we can locate root 2 on a number line. So for that, the first step is first understand how we can find the length of root. For example, there is, let me draw in this side. Okay, let's suppose there is a right angle triangle like this, A B C, and the right angle is at point D. AB is 1 centimeter, BC is 1 centimeter. So by Pythagoras theorem, your AC square will be equal to AB square plus BC square. What is the value of AB? It is 1 square. What is the value of BC? It is 1 square. That means 1 square 1. We know that power of 1, any power of 1 will be 1. Here we get 1 plus 1, 2. So what I got? AC square equals to 2. If I take the square root on both sides, what I will get, AC is equals to root. That means if I am able to draw a triangle whose sides are right angle triangle whose sides are 1 centimeter, so I will get an hypotenuse side whose length will be root. And if I take this length, AC's length, that is the root 2 length, on my compass and put one sharp end on zero, I can directly mark it on the number line. So I'll easily get root 2 located on my number line. Okay. So just follow the steps. This was what I have did here. Okay. Now we know that let's draw a number line where each integer is 1 centimeter separated by each other. I have drawn this approximately, but while drawing on a paper, you have to take the scale and take 1 1 centimeter distance. So this distance, every two number distance will be of 1 centimeter. Okay, so this will be your first step to draw a number line. Take 1 1 centimeter distance always between two integers on a number line. Okay, now write or draw a perpendicular on 1. We know that how to draw perpendiculars. You know this type of shapes you have in your compass. Okay, this type of shape. Just put it on number line, that is 1. Draw a perpendicular at 1 by using it. Right? By using your compass, you can easily draw a perpendicular on 1. So let me draw a perpendicular on 1. Let's suppose you have drawn this. What we'll do, there is this. Let me take the smaller eraser, it will be easier to erase this in this way. Okay. This is your value of 1. Okay. Now take 1 centimeter distance on this side, that is in this perpendicular. So this will be my 1 centimeter. Okay, so let name this A, this is point B, this is point your O. AB is also 1, OB is also 1 centimeter. Okay, now if I join OA, length of OA will be my root 2. This will be my Pythagoras theorem. This we have seen here. This is 1, 1, root 2. Just here instead of C, we have O point. Right? Just put your compass sharp end here and take this distance and mark on this. You will get, this will be your root 2 on number line. Where it is intersecting the this number line, just highlight that intersecting point. You will get your answer of locating root 2 on number line. I believe all of you got this, or it will look like in this way. Here OA, AB, just the name numbers is reverse. This OA is 1, AB is 1. This will be a proper idea you will get, and OB will be root 2. Here you just have to draw, take compass, draw it. Okay, as you know the chalk, one will be your pencil end. Let's suppose the pencil is attached to this and this is your sharp end. Put your sharp end here, draw the pen, your drag your pencil from B point to intersect to the number line. You will get a point P which will be intersecting to the number line, and that point P will be at a distance of root 2 from OP. So this length OP is root 2 distance, and this is the answer of the question. We have to locate root 2 on number. Getting it? Now if you want to locate root 3, what you will do? Next question, locate root 3 on number length. So again same here, you can observe, if I know the length of root 2, for example, length of root 2. Again, second triangle is there, right angle triangle. And if I know this length is, for example, 1, triangle ABC. Again, apply the Pythagoras theorem. So length of AC square will be length of BC square plus length of AB square. What is the value of BC? It is root 2, bracket square. Plus what is the value of AB? It is 1, bracket square. So the value root 2 square will be 2 plus 1 square will be 1. You will get 3. So at right side, what I am getting? 3. Taking square root on both sides, what I will get? AC is equals to root 3. So as soon as I get a length of root 3, same way we have to use a compass to track that length on the to intersect on the number line. You can easily locate root 3, right? So how to find the root 2? Just apply the previous step, you will get root 2. And here on root, let me draw a rough diagram here again. Let's suppose this is your number line. This is your point A, O, this is point 1, and name this point as A, B, C, anything. This will be my minus 1 and minus. What you have done to find root 2? This will be value of your root 2. This is 1. Okay. Just on this side, OA, sorry, OA, draw again a right angle. You know how to find, draw a right angle. Use that shape. Right? So the same thing we are going to do here. Just apply your this concept root 2. To find the root 2, what we are doing? We are making perpendicular at point 1. And by using Pythagoras theorem, this will be my root 2. Let's suppose this is point A. OA is my root 2. Again, draw on OA a perpendicular at point A of 1 centimeter. Now join this. So it will be root 3 by using Pythagoras theorem. We have seen here. If one side is root 2, second side is 1, so the hypotenuse will be root 3. Okay? Getting it? Now just use your compass. Move point the sharping end at O, pencil end at root 3, and just drag. Okay? You will get root 3 where the point is intersecting. Okay? To see this, you can observe here. Here you are. We have seen how to find root 2, and this is BD that we have drawn perpendicular on OB at point B, and it should be of one length, 1 centimeter length. Draw or join OD, it will be of root 3. We have seen here, right? Now put your sharpening end at O and pencil end at point D, drag it at point Q, it will intersect number line. So this point Q will be your root 3. So this is how we can locate root 3 on number line. Okay. Coming to exercise 1.2. So the first question from exercise 1.2 is, state whether the following statements are true or false. Justify your answer. Every irrational number is a real number. Yes, we have seen real number is made up of a rational number and irrational number. That means every irrational number is a real number, but every real number is not irrational number because it could be rational also. So this is true, first one. Second, every point on the number line is of the form root m, where m is natural number. No, not possible. Why? Yes. Is it possible? Okay, sorry, my bad. Because on number line, if it is integer, 1, 2, 3, 0, minus 1, minus 2, and so on. If I want to plot 2, I just need to write 4. So after taking a root 4, it will be minus 2 or 2. Both the numbers can be located. Same for 3, I have to put root 9. For 4, I have to put root 16. And so on. Getting it? And the other numbers we can also plot, that is the irrational numbers. Just put into the root, all the root 2, root 3, all irrational numbers can be written in the form of root that we have seen. And if the rational number is in the form of p by q, it will terminate or not terminate. It will also can be written in the form of root because this p can be written as root of p square. Again, the q can be written as root of q square. For example, if the number is 3 by 5, 5 by 3, okay, we can write it in root form, that is 25 upon 9. But here you can observe, this is it a natural number? No, it is not a natural number. That means this rational number cannot be written in the form of root m, where m is natural number. Here m is natural number, they are saying. If this is not given, then we can write every number in the form of root m, where m is any number or any real number. Okay, but as here m is given as natural number, and we have seen 5 by 3 cannot be written in the form of root m, where m is a natural number. That means this will be my false statement. Okay, this will be my false. Second one is false. You cannot write every point on the number line in the form of root m, where m is natural number. Third, every real number is an irrational number. Every real number is irrational number. No, because the real number is divided into rational number and irrational number. So real number can be rational also. It is not compulsory all real numbers will be irrational only. Okay, so it is also false. Getting it? So this was the first question. Now the second question: are the square roots of all positive integers irrational? Are all the square roots of all positive integers are irrational? That means we have to check square root of positive integers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. What it is asking, whether all the numbers, all the positive integers square root is irrational or not. If I take the square root of 1, it will be 1, so it will be rational number, so it is rational. I'll write q, this is irrational, so I will write q dash. This is again irrational. It's root 4 can be written as 2, so it will be rational. So here you can see and observe, if I am going to write all the positive integers in root, in square root, what I am getting? I am getting sometimes rational and sometimes irrational number. So here root 1 and root 4 are rational numbers, but root 2 and root 3 are irrational numbers. So we can't predict. That depends on the number which is written in square root. If it is a perfect square number, it will be a rational. 1 is perfect square number, 4 is a square perfect square number. If perfect square number is written in square root, as always we can find out the square root and that number will be a rational number. But while explaining irrational number, I have explained, if a non-perfect square number is written in square root, then it will produce an irrational number. So these two will be irrational numbers. Okay, so all square roots of all the square roots of positive integers irrational? No, all are not irrational numbers. Now the second part of the question is, if not, yes, if not, then we have to move. Give an example of the square root of the number that is irrational number. This is the example. This is the example of the square root of a number that is rational. You can also write root 9, root 16, root 25. Just put any perfect square number into square root, it will be a rational number. Okay. You can write as many examples. It is asking you to give any 1-2 example. Okay. Now third question. Show how root 5 can be represented on the number line. As always, just perform the converse. We have seen how to represent an irrational number number line. For example, I have to find this root 5, that is hypotenuse. This we have seen. And one side we are plotting as 1. Just apply the Pythagoras theorem, it will come to 2. Just observe, 2 square will be 4, 1 square will be 1. So AC square will be 5. After taking square root, you will get AC as root 5, just by applying the Pythagoras theorem. It is very simple, that's why I am not writing it again and again. So I have to draw a figure where one side is 2 and one side is 1. So on number line, just do that. On number line, you can easily locate 2, 0, 1, and 2. This will be minus 1. Okay. So this length will be 2. Let name this as B. So this is OB, length will be 2. Just draw a perpendicular. We have seen how to draw the perpendicular. Mark 1 centimeter distance on it. Let's suppose this point is A. Join this OA. So OA will be root 5 by using Pythagoras theorem. As this OB is 2 and BA is 1. By using Pythagoras theorem, OA is root 5. Just put the sharp end of your compass on point O and the pencil point on A. Drag it where it will intersect number line. It will be your root 5. It is as simple as that. Okay. Any doubt, please comment. Now the next point. Here, some division is given. Find a decimal expansion of 10 by 3, 7 by 10, 1 by 7. So instead of writing it again, I have just took the screenshot. This is a very basic, fifth standard, and you have seen this. Here 10 is divided by, in first 10 is divided by 3. In the second 7 by 8 is divided in this second part. And this 1 by 7 is divided, 1 by 7 is divided in this third part. Okay. So just by observing, you can see in second, remainder is 0. And as soon as the remainder is 0, we are not dividing. This basic rule of division we know. Here you can see, always remainder is coming 1, 1, 1, 1. And you are taking 0, again dividing it by 3. 3 3s are 9, again 1. This process is going to be continued. So here you can see, when we divide 10 by 3, the answer is 3.33. That is 10 by 3 answer in decimal point is 3.33. Instead of writing 33 again and again, we are putting the bar on 3. 3.3 bar, that means 3 is repeating and not terminating. It is not terminating, means it is not having a break. It is continuously repeating. Okay. And in second, you can observe, as soon as we got the remainder 0, we got the perfect answer. That is, answer for 7 by 8 in decimal is 0.875. That means it is terminating. Terminating means we are not getting infinite numbers after division. As soon as we get the remainder 0, we stop the division. Okay. So in first observation, what we seen, in first it is repeating, in second one it is terminating. We know that if it is repeating, then it is a rational number. So it is a rational number denoted by Q. It is also a rational number because it is terminating. Now in seventh, in third, divide 1 by 7. What you are getting, this number 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7 is repeating. So these 6 numbers are repeating. If I start dividing 1 again by 7, I'll get again 1, 7, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7. So these 6 numbers are repeated. So instead of writing it again and again, 1 by 7 can be written as 0.142857 bar, because the 6 digits are repeating in this division. Okay. It is also repeating and non-terminating. So it is also a rational number. When a number is terminating or repeating, then it is called rational number. And if a number is not possessing any of these two properties, that is neither terminating nor repeating, then that number, that decimal number, will be called as irrational number, that we have seen. Okay. So observe this while dividing. Now coming to the next topic, this was only an observation that I wanted to tell you. Now in decimal expansion, here you can see this 3.142678 is terminating. They are not giving any dot dot after it or a bar on it. That means it is terminating. So here the number 3.4267, it is terminating, and as it is terminating, it is rational number. So we know that a rational number is of the form p by q, but here it is in the form of decimal. We have converted your rational number in decimal form in this previous one, right? 10 by 3 is written in decimal form, 7 by 2 is again written in decimal form. So here we, if the question is, we have to reverse the situation or reverse the representation. That is, if the decimal is given, they are asking you to convert into p by q form, that is the fraction form. Okay, so how to convert it? If it is terminating, there will be two types. If the number, that number can be terminating or repeating. So if the number is terminating, that is the decimal is terminating, so it will be very easy. Just remove that decimal point, write all the numbers as it is, divide it by 1, write 1, and as many zeros as the digits after 0. Here how many digits are there after 0? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 6 zeros you have to put after 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It will be the representation of this in p by q form. Very easy. For example, the second example we'll take. For example, 0.367 is given. Okay. How you will write? Just remove this decimal point, just write all the numbers after removing decimal point, divide it by 1 and put the number of as many number of zeros as the digits after decimal point. Here how many digits are there after decimal point? 1, 2, and 3. That means 3 zeros you have to put after 1, that is you have to divide it by 1000. So this will be the representation of your decimal in p by q form if it is terminating. So the if the question is in terminating form, it will be very easy to convert. Now coming to the non-terminating or repeating numbers, if repeating decimal is given, here you can see repeating decimal is given. As we know that it is a rational number and it can be written as in the form of p by q. So we have to see the process. If the number is repeating, if the decimal is repeating, so the first step is take, I'll write here, steps, take x equals to that given number, or let, you can write let x equals to the given number. So here, while solution or while proof, you can write x equals to your 0.3333 and so on. Okay. Now, second step will be multiply by 10 to the power m, where m is equals to number of repeating digits. Number of repeating. Here you can see how many digits are repeated. Only 3 is repeated, that is only 1. So the value of m will be my 1, right? In this case only, value of m will be my 1, and 10 to the power m, that is 10 to the power 1 will be 1, 10. Okay, so we have to multiply by 10 to the both side. So here what I will write, multiply both side by 10. So what I will get, 10 into x, 10x equals to 10 into this 0.3333 and so on. You can see you have to shift your decimal to the right hand side by the number of digits. And how to find that number of digits? Check the number of zeros. Here 10 is there, that means I have to shift my decimal to the right hand side by 1 only. So what I will get, 3.3333 and so on. Okay, so what I got, 10x equals to 3.33 and so on. Okay, now the third step, subtract number obtained on right hand side, that is this side, by your x. X means the given number. It is given question. Given question or given number. Okay. So here subtract it. I am writing in the red ink for our example. Here the right hand side was 3.3333 and so on. We have to subtract it by our x. What is the value of x? It was 0.3333. Right? So you can observe after decimal. You have to write the decimal below the decimal. This 3333 will be cancelled. So it will be 0000 point. 3 minus 0 will be 3. So what I got? 3. So just you have to write the number obtained by subtraction plus your x. What was x? That is 0.333. So I have just represented this number in this form only. I have not done any rocket science. Okay. To explain this, I have made a step 3. It will be easy to understand. And it will be very easy. This algorithm will be very easy to apply to solve any of the given question of this type. Now here you can observe. This is 3 plus. What is the value of this? We have considered it as x. So 10x equals to 3 plus x. Shift your x to the right hand, left hand side. What I will get? 10x minus x equals to 3. Right? Now what I will get? 10x minus x, 9x equals to 3. Divide this 9 to the right hand side. What I will get? X equals to 3/9. That means x is equals to 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9. That is 1/3. Right? So here, what was the value of x? It was 0.333, that is 0.3 is converted into p by q form. As they are equal, that means I can write 0.333 bar as 1/3. Getting it? In this way, we have converted our decimal into the fraction part, that is p by q form. Both are irrational numbers. I believe everyone got this. So just you need to apply these three steps to find or to convert any decimal number, which is a rational number, into the form of p by q. Okay. Let's take the second example for this. Same process we are going to apply. Here you can see we have to show 1.2727, that is 1.27 bar in the form of p by q, where p by q are integers. What I said, the first step is improve. What is the first step? Take or let x equals to the given number. Now what will you are? Let x is as given number, which is 1.27 bar. Okay. Now the second step is multiply the given number by 10 to the power m, where m is the number of repeating digits. So 10 to the power m, we have to multiply. What is the value of m here? Number of digits, repeating digits. Here how many digits are repeating? 2 digits are repeating, right? That means m will be 2. Put m as 2. 10 to the power 2. What will be its value? It is 100. That means we have to multiply by 100. So just write, multiply both side by 100. What you will get? 100x equals to here 100 into, for the sake of simplicity I am writing in this form. Here I have just explained you how to adjust your 100 with or 10 to the power with your decimal point. Count how many number of zeros are there and shift decimal point to the right hand side by the same number. Here how many numbers, number of zeros are there? 2. That means we have to shift our 0 to the right hand side by 2. So what I will get? 1, 2, 7, 0.27, 27, dot, dot, dot. ओके, एटलीस्ट 127.2727। नाउ व्हाट वाज द थर्ड स्टेप? वी हैव टू सब्सट्रैक्ट द नंबर ऑब्टेंड ऑन राइट हैंड साइड बाय आर एक्स, बट इट शुड बी डन इन रफ वर्क। ओके, सो दिस नंबर ऑब्टेंड ऑन राइट हैंड साइड should be subtracted by the value of x. What was the value? X, that is 1.27. So it will 1.2727 and so on, right? Here you can see. So here these are all the numbers, all the digits on the right hand side of both the numbers are same. 1 minus 2 minus 2, 7 minus 7, 2 minus 2, 7 minus 7. All will be 0 after subtraction. Again, now on the right hand, left hand side of the decimal, 127 minus 1 will be 126. That means I can write the number obtained, that is 126. No need to write 00 after decimal point. Plus your x, what was your x? That is 1.2727 and so on. So here you can observe, I have done only an adjustment. 127.2727 can be written back in this sense, right? These two numbers addition can be done and it will be 127.2727, right? We know that what is the value of this? It is x, we have considered it as x, 1.27 bar, right? Now shift your x to the left hand side, what you will get? 100x minus 100x equals to 126. So what you will get? 99x equals to 126. So what will be the value of x? It is 126 upon 99. And what was the x? That was 1.27 bar. 126 upon 99. So here you can see we have converted our decimal rational number into the form of p by q. Just follow the given steps. Any question you can solve. So these steps are very important. You should have a note of it. Memorize the steps. You can solve any number of questions. Okay. So just go through all the topics which we have covered. Try to solve exercise 1.1, 1.2. Go through all the theory written in the book. Also, which I have explained in this video. And we'll see in the next session. Till then, stay safe and work hard.